Check out this program, giving away 100 milligrams Miracle just 876. CBS and Walgreens don't want you to know about this because they sell the same kind of $30 to $40 each. Don't believe me? Yes. It's from CBS. Look, 9 tablets, 100 milligrams of Benadryl, 406 dollars. This is from Walgreens. $417, 9 tablets, 100 milligrams of Benadryl, for $46. Now get the same 9 tablets, the same 100 milligram strength, the Friday pleasures for just 87 cents each. To get your brand new Friday plans, text GENEGEN to 69062. Once you text, they will send you a special link. All you need to do is select Friday weekend Viagra, quantity, and the dose of okay, 100 milligram. And then their system is in your car. Get a simplified best deal. And, hey, look at that. 87 cents for each 100 milligrams of their Viagra tablet. Prescription should be free. Viagra plans remove your medication from any one tablet, just like this one's been created. So, you'll find this system. Each tablet is individually wrapped. So you can tear one off, put it in your pocket. Guys, you need a generic Viagra. Friday plans offer a special deal for your customers. $10 off your first pack. Prescription is free and shipping is free as well. Do not wait. Text GENEG to 69069 today.
New York City was safer than it had been in decades. With crime plummeting across all boroughs, except one, the Bronx. Where news teacher Jonathan Penn dedicated his life to proving to his students that there is life beyond the streets. Jonathan loved the very day thing, he wanted to make a difference in the lives of the students.
They should respect. They value that very much and we believe in them. No matter where they come from, and no matter the struggle they go through, they were there to help them. I was going to a workshop about restructuring the school. All the teachers were going to be there. John was in charge of restructuring one of the group for English. At this point, we were getting very close. That's when we like spending a lot of time together. And we started a relationship. school after having perfect attendance for 3 years of education, I did something really wrong. I was trying to ask every colleague that I know if they have seen him, or the male colleagues, and they said, oh, he's okay, don't worry about him. But all day, I couldn't sit down. I was like moving back and forth, and I said, I do not know what to do. So my female colleague went to his apartment that night to check on him. I couldn't get in, but I will never forget the sound coming to his door. So I started like crying. And this is when my colleague called 911.
I guess we were kind of wrong. I get it off of the wall. There were two uniformed police officers and these teachers, friends of Johnny. They were very concerned about Johnny's letter. I have a key to Johnny's apartment because we had an aspirin that we had to work with who back off the dog man. So I went to the apartment, but as soon as I opened the door, I smelled a putrid smell. The apartment was totally dark. I couldn't see anything. And still, we didn't go to what was great in there. John could get I could see the injuries on the floor. I saw a very dark shape on the floor. And that's when I said, oh my God, I think the dog is dead. And my eyes got more adjusted to the dog, and I can see it wasn't the dog. I can see it was a body.
Tells us a lot about the intent of the person who was there. He was tortured and he was shot. Why? They needed something from him. It's the normal thing that they would need from money. There was a lot. And he didn't have his bank card. He couldn't find it. McKenna makes a note to look into Johnson's recent banking. In New York, anyone could be the target of a robbery, but Johnson's apartment wasn't instantly screened well to protect him.
Or a building. It wasn't like a slum, but it wasn't an expensive building. It didn't have a door handle or anything like that. It's a brick pre-war with small apartments. In New York, it needs a glorified closet. I wouldn't say it was bare bones, but it was close to that.
McKenna turns his attention to the messy condition of Johnson's apartment. A lot of food, bottles. Somebody had been drinking meat. There were two plates of Chinese food, and the food was still on the plate. So two people were in the process of literally sharing meat. It was no force entry. So I think Jonathan knew who killed him.
They still had my door open at 4 o'clock in the morning. There was still a Grand Central Station going on. And then the police were coming out the door. And I said, where are you taking the door? And they said, the door was locked up in the bedroom this whole time. So I grabbed Julius and I go out of the building. This is the first time I walked out of the building. And there is an army of media. Every network in New York City was parked in front of my apartment. I was a reporter for a Time Warner startup called New York One. I found myself covering this story from the outside of the apartment. In cases of murder, especially in a neighborhood like the Upper West Side, it's a big story. At some point, my news director told me, this is the boss's son.
Coming up,
you are one of the most powerful men in New York. You're something.